Hi everyone, how do you do? Yesterday, in my thermodynamics class, one of my students asked me how to design this donut chart in Microsoft Excel, and I told him this is thermodynamics class. Why are you asking Excel question? He told me it had been a challenge between him and his girlfriend, and none of them could solve the problem yet, and he asked me to help him to win the challenge. And I told him,
Challenge accepted.
today I'm going to show you how to design this beautiful donut chart like engineers. It's gonna be legend.
Dairy. Legendary.
We have the delivery report and we want to draw a donut chart for it. So select the variables and from the Insert tab, add a donut chart. Let's simplify it and change its color. Set this color for the background and remove the outline. Click once on the donut and remove the outline from it. While the donut is selected, click once more on this section and change its color. Repeat this for the other section. You know, we can't internally make the edges rounded. We have to do it externally. Let me add a circle to the sheet and duplicate it. This approach is very good and fast, but it is not dynamic. I mean, if I change the percentage, the circle doesn't follow it. I need to find a dynamic way for it. Can you tell me how? With the help of a scatter chart. This is a scatter chart which I have simplified, and the position of points are dependent to the percentage. Now, if I drag it over the donut chart, you can see a donut chart with round edges. By choosing different percentage, you can see that their positions update automatically. Let me show you how to do it properly. Since we want a dynamic chart, we have to do it inside the donut chart. Right-click on the donut and click on Select Data. Let's add the new data to the chart. Since it is a donut chart, we can't enter the X and Y values together. So I only select the X value and will modify it further. Now we have to change the chart type. Right-click on it and select Change Chart Type. In the OpenEd window from right list, click on the combo chart. Select Doughnut chart for the delivery report and choose this scatter chart for the points. Click on OK. Let's modify the points chart. Right click on the chart and click on Select Data. In this window, select Points and edit it. Modify the X and Y values and click on OK. Since we want the center of chart in this area, we have to modify the axis. Right-click on this axis and select Format Axis. Change the maximum and minimum to 1 and minus 1. By doing this, we are transforming the 0 on axis to the center. Select the other axis and repeat this. Okay, now the point is in its position. Let's increase the size of it. Right-click on the point and select Format Data Series. Go to the Fill and Line section and select Marker Options. From the built-in section, change its size. Also, change its color and remove the outline. Now we have to increase the size of donut to fit them together. But how can I find the exact value? If I select donut, you can see that the hole size is 50%. It means if I consider the length of this section 1 unit, the length of this section is 1 unit as well. We know that the center of point is in the middle of filled donut. So it means we have 4 equal units. And also we know that the length of point's center is equal to 1. Which means the length of 3 units are equal to 1. What is the length of 4 units? It is equal to 1.3. So if I increase the size of axis from minus 1.3 to 1.3, the donut and point will fit together precisely. Okay, this was the fixed part, but what about the other side? It is not fixed. I mean, its position changed by changing the percentage value. For finding the exact position, we need some mathematical calculations. But don't worry, it is so easy. We learned all of them in high school. To find the exact position, we have to use the sine and cosine values. We can calculate the sine of alpha by dividing the x length by the radius. Since we considered the radius equal to 1, we can conclude that the x value is equal to the sine of alpha. And we have the same condition for the y value, which is equal to the cosine of alpha. Okay, the problem is solved. We located the exact position of x and y for the next edge. But maybe you ask, how can I calculate the alpha? It is so easy. We know that a circle is equal to 360 degrees. It means 100% is equal to 360 degrees. So let's see how many degrees is 1%. It is equal to 3.6 degrees. Let's calculate the alpha for 25%. We know that each percent is equal to 3.6 degrees. Now, if we multiply it by the percentage, we can calculate the alpha. Keep in mind that we have to multiply it by 100 to convert percentage to number. It is equal to 90 degrees. We can simplify the function like this. Alpha is equal to 360 multiplied by the percentage. Okay, let's add the second point to the chart. The x value is equal to the sine of alpha, and alpha is equal to 360 multiplied by the percentage. And we learned that the y value is equal to the cosine of alpha. Now we have to add the new point to the chart. So click on the point in the chart and add the new point to the chart. But there is a problem. Why the second point isn't in its exact location? The reason is that Excel can't recognize degrees. So we have to first convert degrees to numbers and then calculate the sine or cosine. How can we convert degree to number? By using the radian function. So let's modify the functions and convert degree to radian. Congratulations, you have created this beautiful donut chart. Now, if I enter different percentage, you can see that the chart updates automatically. I have a challenge for you. I want you to tell me the exact size of axis when we select 75% for donut hole size. So pause the video and think about it. I know most of you could answer this challenge because we spoke about it earlier in this video. When we select 75% for the hole size, it means this section is 3 units and this one is 1 unit. And the center of point is in the middle of filled donut and the length of it is equal to 1. So if you look at the chart precisely, the lengths of 3.5 units are equal to 1. What is the length of 4 units? It is equal to 1.14. So I have to modify the size of the axis to the new value. Now we have to decrease the points sizes as well. Perfect. Now remove the axis and enjoy your donut chart. And finally, if you think this video was helpful, please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, it was all for today's video. I'll see you next video.